Hi friends, in my previous video, I have already explained about structure of human eye. Now let's see defects of vision. But before starting this video, I like to share few points about my videos. Friends, you try to watch the video total and try to comment me in the below so that I can rectify whatever the doubts you have and whatever the changes you want to need me. So if you comment me, I can make over many changes in the videos so that you can understand in better way. So friends, try to check the videos until the last. So I hope I am explaining each point, so it will take more time. So don't worry about the time. So the matter, you will gather the information, it is important. So try to check every point and try to understand each point, and at last try to comment in the below so that I can change them whatever you want. Okay friends, let's start to our topic, that is defects of vision. So what are the defects we will see? So note I have taken, this is the important point before starting our video. So the distance between the lens and retina is about 2.5 centimeters. That is, for any position of the object in front of the eye, the image distance is fixed and about 2.5 centimeters. So this point I will explain same. I already explained about structure of eye, and I have taken the diagram for our ease understanding. So here the lens and retina, these two plays major role. So whatever the distance is there between them is 2.5 centimeters, and whatever the image is forming after the lens, it should be formed exact on the retina. So if the image is forming in front of the retina, that is less than 2.5 centimeters, and after the retina, that is more than 2.5 centimeters, then in these two cases we will get the defects. So let's check what is the distance of the image is playing major role in the defects. So try to check the video until the last, once again I am saying, for better understanding. So let's go. If image is not formed on retina, then the person will experience blurred image, and it may be the chances of no vision too. So this is the problem. See, if the image is not at all forming on exact on the retina, it leads to the blur image. Or in some cases, if the defect is increasing, it leads to final chance, then the person cannot see the image at all. So this is the problem of this formation of image, if it is not at all in proper way. So let's go. Defects of vision. There are mainly three common defects of vision. They are myopia, hypermetropia and presbyopia. So let's check the myopia. Myopia is the first one I have taken. It is the nearsightedness. So let's check. Some people can't see objects at long distance but can see nearby objects clearly. This type of vision is called myopia. It is also called nearsightedness. So friends, for this point I will explain. See, the persons who can see the objects at near distance but they cannot see the objects at far. So this type of situation or this type of defect is called myopia. So as you are seeing near distance objects, so it is called as the nearsightedness. So don't get confused here. It is the basic point. You will get confused what is nearsightedness and farsightedness. Based on the vision, it given the nearsightedness. As you are seeing near objects, it is called nearsightedness, and this defect is called myopia. So for these people, the maximum focal length is less than 2.5 centimeters. In such cases, the rays coming from the distant objects after refraction through the eye lens form an image before the retina, as shown in figure 2. So for this total point, I have taken the diagram. The diagram explains each matter. Same, I have taken the eyeball where the lens is there and the formation of the image. The rays are coming from the object, but after passing through the lens, the image is forming less than 2.5 centimeters distance, that is before the retina. Here the image is forming exact, it should be formed on the retina. So as it is forming before the retina of less than 2.5 centimeters, we are getting the myopia. So this defect is called myopia, and in this case we are getting the image blur due to the formation of image before of the retina. This is the first case. So how to correct this defect? So I have taken further also diagram. Let's check. For the correction of defect of myopia and the formation of undesired errors in rays of about biconcave lens is used. So friends, a total to correct the myopia disease, the biconcave lens is used. So I will explain the diagram. See, the rays which are coming from the object, it passes from the biconcave lens and it finally it reaches exact on the retina. So by this the myopia defect is rectified. So here you have to remember the one point is the correction of the myopia. The correction of myopia can be done by biconcave lens. Next, myopia is defect in age of less than 20. So normally this can be seen the people who are in the school age and the people who are in the teenagers. So this is the defect normally you can observe in them, that is myopia. So let's go to the second point, that is hypermetropia. So hypermetropia exact reverse of myopia. So hypermetropia is also known as a farsightedness. A person with hypermetropia can see objects clearly but cannot see objects at near distance, because the focal length of eye lens for the person of hypermetropia is greater than 2.5 centimeters. That is, the image formation is after the retina. For this total I will explain. So if you take the rays from the object, the rays it passes from the lens but it will not form on the retina, it will fall after the retina. So this is exact after of myopia scene. So in myopia you observe the image will be formed in front of the retina, but in hypermetropia the image is forming after the retina. So to rectify this defect of hypermetropia, we will take the lenses of biconvex. So let's check the point. To correct the rays error, the defect of hypermetropia, we can use the biconvex lens. So I have taken the diagram as usual. So friends, in this case rays from the object are passing through the biconvex lens and after passing the lens it reaches exact on the retina. If the image rays are forming on the retina, then we can see the clear image. So this is the correction for the hypermetropia. The lens used is biconvex lens. As we have seen correction of hypermetropia, let's check in which age group maximum we will see this hypermetropia. So the age group is hypermetropia generally we can observe in the age of 20 to 25 age, that is 13.2%, and in the age of 40 to 45, it is normal the age of our parents, we can observe them. They cannot see the near objects but they can see the far objects. So this is the age group they given, that is 17.4%. We can take this note, the rating is increasing from 13.2% to 17.4%, it is increased as the age is increasing. This is the defects and this is the correction about hypermetropia. Coming to presbyopia, it is normally in the aging factor, that is in the old age we will get. Let's check. This happens due to the gradual weakening of ciliary muscles and diminishing flexibility of eye lens. This effect can be seen in aged people. Sometimes a person may suffer from both myopia and hypermetropia with aging. According to this point, we can observe that if the age is increasing, the ciliary muscles, they will get weak. If ciliary muscles are getting weak, what happens? The image, the lens cannot adjust according to the object rays. So as they are not adjusting according to the object rays, the image formation will be totally blur. The image formation will be in front of the retina and after the retina. So this is the two cases. We can observe here, see, the person may be suffering both from myopia and hypermetropia. This is maximum occurred in the aging, means the old age people will occur this. As the age increases, we can observe this presbyopia. To rectify this defect, we have to use the lenses of made with two lens, that is concave lens and convex lens. Let's check the point. To correct this type of defect of vision, we need bifocal lenses, which are formed by using both concave and convex lens. Its upper portion is consists of concave lens and lower portion is consists of convex lens. So this is the case. I have taken two angles. So this is two concave and the convex lenses, which is called as the bifocal lenses. With the use of these bifocal lenses, we can rectify the presbyopia. So friends, once again I will repeat total. So try to check whatever the matter. If you are missing, you can gather the information now. So don't miss now. These last minutes are important. Normally we have three types of defects, that is myopia, hypermetropia, presbyopia. Myopia is also called as the nearsightedness. Why? Because
we will see the objects at near distance. We cannot see the distance at long distance. Normally, this will occur in teenagers or in the school age people, the school age students. Next, the image is total, the figure 2 explains the defect of myopia. The rays are coming from the object, and after passing the lens, they are forming in front of the retina. So we can observe in the figure, the image is forming in front of the retina. To rectify this defect, we can use this. The correction is biconcave lens. Let's check this. For the correction of defect of myopia, the formation of undesired errors or the biconcave lens is used. Whatever the rays are coming from the object, it will be passed from the biconcave lens and it will be formed exact on the retina. This is the point we have to remember. The biconcave lens is used to rectify or to correct the myopia disease or myopia defect. Coming to hypermetropia, exact opposite of myopia. In this case, the image will be formed after the retina. So to rectify this, we have to use the biconvex lens. That is the case. If you use the biconvex lens, the image will be formed exact on the retina. So this is totally opposite of myopia. Coming to presbyopia, the presbyopia will be occur in the old people. So in this case, they cannot see the near distance and far distance. To rectify this, we are using the bifocal lenses. Normally, these will occur in the aging people, that is old people. And hypermetropia, it will be normally seen in the age group of 40 to 45. As the age increases, the hypermetropia can be converted into presbyopia, where the defects of two can be occurred, that is myopia and hypermetropia. So friends, I already said, for your better understanding, you have to check the structure of human eye first. So first, you see the structure of human eye. I will give the video's link in the description. Next, coming to this topic, you have to see until the last to understand the three defects of the vision. And finally, subscribe my channel for more videos.